you're off.
AGI is going to happen, and it will change how the economy operates, and it will change how the internet works in very meaningful ways. So there are certain parts of the internet where we clearly need a human gate, almost. Like, you can only enter this if you're an actual human being, otherwise please stay out of this. And that is what World Eddy is in its purest form. I am Alex Blania. I am CEO of Tools for Humanity, which is the founding and one of the main contributing entities to the Worldcoin project. We believe that, and I think at this point it's fairly obvious, that in the coming years, 90%+ of everything we interact with and see will be somewhat created or enhanced by AI. And that is a problem. It's not a problem for everything. Actually, it's very fun and cool for most things because it's just very entertaining. You will be able to create the perfect song that you like, just with kind of a simple ask. You will be able to create the perfect video. So these are all great things. But there's other parts of the internet. I think X or Twitter is actually a good example, where it's not in all of our interest if people with certain interests can influence broad public opinion with tens of thousands of instances of AI that follow a certain idea. But now we are in the situation where I really do believe in the next 2 years, we are faced with two options. Either we will enforce government KYC at a pretty large scale for many things that we use, or we use World Eddy. So fundamentally, on a protocol level, it's two things. It is a way to verify humanness truly at population scale, independent of governments, able to scale to billions of people. And that is what we call World ID, which underlying is a biometric verification device that we call the ORB, that you see here, that actually allows us to do that. So that is World ID, that's building block one. And two is a digital currency called Worldcoin, that everyone that actually verifies for World ID receives ownership in it. That is the protocol level. And then also, to get all of this going, we built the first app that connects to the protocol that we called World App. So that's a non-custodial wallet that lets you send money to your friends, lets you verify with your World ID, and kind of brings together many of the technologies that came out of crypto in the last couple of years and just makes them very easy to understand and use.
So as we started building out the Worldcoin network, we realized that one of the hardest parts, if not the hardest, honestly, was just going to be figuring out who was a real person and who was not in the first place to let into the network. And so we researched for many, many years, tried a lot of different things. At the end of the day, we came up with this idea of World ID, which is a digital passport that allows you to prove that you're a real human on the internet while preserving your privacy. So when we set out to solve this problem of how do you figure out what is a real and unique person, we tried a bunch of different things that you can imagine, right? Verifying people's emails and phone number, verifying their official documents like a passport, doing complex algorithms to have people endorse each other, and a bunch of other things. And at the end of the day, you realize that the only thing that is privacy preserving, inclusive, and honestly just actually secure is biometrics.
I know it sounds scary, it's from like sci-fi novels, et cetera, Minority Report. It turns out it's the only way to, in an inclusive manner that allows everybody in the world to participate, to issue such a proof of unique humanness. But with an iris biometrics, we could have, or we thought of using existing devices. Like, the last thing we wanted to do, as much fun as it was to build something like an orb, is it's actually really, really hard. It takes a lot of time, and we thought about other ways to do this, but it turns out that they're not built for the same purpose. So in the end, we had to build a custom hardware device to actually enable something like Worldcoin from both like an accuracy inclusivity perspective as well as from a security perspective. Essentially what the orb does is like it takes a look at everybody who's coming, verifies that you're a real human, you're not wearing a mask, you're not a display, you're not a house cat, but a real human. Then it issues a proof of human certificate, essentially, that we call World ID. And that you then own in your app, and you can use it to authenticate against different or for different applications and prove that you're a unique human.
Yeah, so one of the most counterintuitive things about Worldcoin is that the Orb and World ID are not just private, but they're perhaps one of the most private systems at this scale that have ever existed. And specifically, there's three different layers of protection of privacy that I think is important to understand. Number one is the Orb is able to perform all of these checks on device with different neural networks. The second layer of protection is the fact that your biometrics are separate from your World ID. You can actually even have a World ID before you visit an Orb. What the Orb does is it simply marks your World ID as verified. So when you do go around using that World ID, it's completely separate from any biometric data. And then the third layer of protection, it's actually quite similar to what Apple shipped a few years ago that actually broke Facebook's entire advertising model. And so the way this works is when you go around using your ID with different World ID apps, you're not even sharing your actual ID. You're almost like creating a disposable ID so that each app gets a different version of your ID, which they can use to provide you a persistent experience. You can sign in and sign out, but they cannot see or track anything you've done anywhere else with your World ID. So with these three layers of protection, the fact that the Orb is able to perform these checks on device, the fact that your biometrics are not your identity, but only used to verify your World ID, and the fact that every time you're using your World ID, you're generating a different disposable app-specific ID, just makes World ID, again, not just private, but one of the most private things out there, period.
So decentralization means that there is no central party that can make the system fail. That's fundamentally what it means. And so if I'm right with my assumption that Worldcoin will be as a fundamental shift as I think it will be, it is very, very important that there will not be a single entity, not me, not the Worldcoin Foundation, not anyone else, that can either be attacked externally or internally come up with bad ideas or stupid ideas to compromise the whole idea of the project. That's why it matters. There is a non-profit foundation called the Worldcoin Foundation that is fully out of mine and Sam's control, and that actually has all of the IP, all of the important IP that has been created here is controlled by a non-profit foundation. And why does it exist? Why is it not a normal company? Fundamentally, because all the governance eventually will switch to become all of humanity. This idea that every individual being able to prove to the internet that you're a unique human being will be a big building block of this. Because once you have solved that, that is something that doesn't exist right now on the internet. Once you have solved that, you can actually launch a digital currency by giving ownership in it to every human being, because everyone can prove that they didn't claim a share in it before. And as a result, bootstrap a billion plus people network and trust that kind of the size of the network and the resulting network effects will accelerate many, many things in the world that we think are strictly good. I do think World ID can actually do great service to society by being an open source, actual public good that we can all understand and we can trust. And of course, there's still a long way to go, but I think that's kind of where we're headed.